And when Jesus got into the boat, his disciples followed him. A windstorm arose on the sea, so great that the boat was being swamped by the waves. But he was asleep. And they went and woke him up, saying, "Lord, save us. We're perishing." And he said to them, "Why are you afraid, you of little faith?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a dead calm. They were amazed, saying, "What sort of man is this that even the winds and the sea obey him?"
I had cancer treatment, and I'm very afraid of these cats.
Yeah.
Going underneath it to the point where I can't even go through them at an airport. But I remember very distinctly, I said, "Jesus, you promised you'd be with me, and I feel so abandoned." And it came to me so clearly, "Elaine, I never said that you wouldn't go through storms. I said I would be in the boat with you."
Oh.
And you know, that got me through everything.
Very good, yes. No, he never really abandons us. He may not allow us to experience his presence because of our fear or claustrophobia. I can't go into any of those machines, and I refuse.
You do?
I do. I will not go. Last time I was in the hospital, they put me through anyway, CAT scans and I said to them, you have no idea what it does to me.
Yeah.
And they said, "Well, we could give you something." I said, "That we've tried that in the past. It doesn't work. I'm overwhelmed by the enclosure." And I said, "It becomes very, very painful." Mm. And I start yelling at them, you know, "Get me out of here."
Oh, wow, that makes me feel good.
Jesus speaks to us of our response to fear. The story asks us to look at the area of trust in our lives, especially trust in God. When the going gets tough, to whom do we turn? Are we like the apostles, or do we turn to Christ our Savior? He can calm even the most disturbing of our interior life. Jesus says, "Trust in me." Do we?
This is pretty hard to do when you're really afraid, because like you said, you have no control over that fear.
But what I do is very much like what you do. I just ask the Lord to be present to my fear, to the fear that I am experiencing inside. Because I don't really feel that he's abandoning me or anything. I just see it as my human weakness that is revealing itself in this claustrophobic fear.
Yes.
And so I often say to myself, when I say, "No, I will not go into the MRI machine ever again," am I refuting something that God has provided for my welfare? Or am I free to say, "No, I don't want to go through that again"?
Lord, help me now to face this battle.
Fear, by Father Bob. Disturbing, destructive, unnerving, paralyzing, cloying fear attacks. More binding than forged chains, it tightens the bonds. Weakening its victim into simpering insensibility, it securely imprisons. Terror and anxiety, its other names, wreaks havoc in mind and heart. Danger impending, its source so often is inhibiting breathing, functioning. There is nothing worse to detract from normalcy than dreadful, cloying fear. Suffer it once, and you will understand the damp hands and hair, solicitude, kind and true, its conqueror is, restoring restful calm.
And so as we think of the various experiences of storms that we have been in life, that terrify us, that make us think that we're perishing and that all is lost, we hear the words of this gospel lesson as Jesus rebukes the winds and the sea and brings that calm, that great peace, so that we wonder at who is this that can bring peace in the storm. So let us pray. O God, our defender, storms rage about us and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters from fear. And preserve us all from unbelief through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.